even an eating disorder, genetics, or
I've been
Hollywood
criticized
pressure.
For losing too much weight.
Hollywood's giant summer slim down.
She's even anorexic.
Tanner, Blondheck!
What would happen if I did everything the media suggested I do? Would I look like a celebrity at the end of it? Would my life be as perfect as they say? My name is Maddie Humphreys. I've never dieted before. I've never exercised excessively. I've never dyed my hair or even got a spray tan. But for 10 weeks, I'm going to try it all. Every week, I will test a new diet, exercise regime, and beauty treatment. Praised by my favorite celebrities, the hottest Hollywood trends. If they say it, then I'll do it. 1,000 to 1,200 calories a day, check. The suggested daily intake for weight loss. 3 hours exercise every single day, check. The Victoria's Secret workout regime. And live life glamorously with no cheating, check. And at the end of all this, stand in front of my friends, family, and followers and hopefully present myself as perfect. So, am I perfect?
Am I perfect? Hey!
How hard could perfect really be? Never really ever thought that I was obese.
Top priority would probably be uni. Second would probably be family, friends.
I don't really want to talk to people. I don't want to socialize. When people compliment you or, you know, say, oh, you're looking great, and it's like, well, not really, it's just the makeup.
You start to see food not as like energy or nutrition as an enemy.
It's very difficult to get enough calories to run an adult human body using baby foods alone.
It's actually gonna make me gag.
I can feel my paleo egg breakfast coming back up.
Oh, I'm really nervous.
I've never felt like this, and I don't think anyone would ever want to.
Following one of the toughest weeks I have ever endured, one that rattled me both mentally and physically, I had to spend the weekend really contemplating whether I should continue with this experiment. But knowing that other women are going through this, as we are so often told, I felt that if I were to quit now, then maybe I was inadequate. I had to keep going. I couldn't bear the thought of failing myself, so I decided to continue on. I started week 4 off unable to cook anything on the raw foods diet. I also would have my first taste of the popular CrossFit workout and finish off the week dreading a second trip to the beauty salon.
So, last week's baby food. And it was probably my hardest week yet. The biggest thing was the emotional roller coaster.
Yeah.
I just couldn't believe that anyone would do that, especially with the mood swings.
Yeah. You've probably reached a time in the whole process that the wheels were going to start falling off at about this point, even if you'd followed the same fad diet for 3 weeks. So it's that plus, 3 to 5 jars of baby food is not really enough even for a baby. I think you've proven, actually, that it's very unlikely that any real human follows this for any extended period of time.
Mm. I've weighed myself and I've lost 10 kilograms in 3 weeks.
Well, starvation will do that.
Yeah. Is that an extreme?
Yes, yeah. Absolutely. Yeah, it's certainly beyond anything that I would ever recommend.
This week, I've moved on to raw foods.
With raw fruit and veg, you've got your carbohydrates from the fruit sugars, basically, that's it. And the veg, because you're not allowed to cook it, then there's no starchy component, so there's no carbohydrate in the vegetables. Are you having nuts?
Yeah, a few, because they're so high in calories, I've had to really restrict.
The only main source of protein is from nuts. There's a bit of protein here and there in fruit and veg, but it's not their characterising ingredients. It's not why they exist in the food supply.
Yeah.
And for a grown woman, you would need at least 1.5 cups to provide you with your basic protein requirements. So again, it's going to be a week where you're using your own muscle stores. Not only have you got a diet that's insufficient in protein to keep your normal functions going, insufficient in carbohydrates, insufficient in fat. I mean, it's a starvation diet, this time just with a bit of fibre in it.
After hearing Fiona's disapproval, I was very suspicious of my new diet. The raw food diet is based on the fundamental principle that plant-based foods are healthiest in their natural raw state. The diet boasts that while you lose weight, it will also boost your energy, improve your digestion, clear up your skin, and provide wonderful overall health. And all this without having to lift a finger in the kitchen. And when I heard that the extremely sexy Tomb Raider, Angelina Jolie, is a living and breathing raw foodie, it was a no-brainer that I should adventure down the same track. The first meal I was preparing was a mushroom soup, blended until warm.
Oh, that is not nice. Onion is very overpowering. This is probably one of the saddest things I've cooked in the whole experiment. Oh god.
Having to keep up my sun-kissed celebrity glow, I stripped off for my second spray tan.
First week she lost 5 kilograms.
The first week?
And she's like, on last week, I only lost, like, which was the third week. She's like, I only lost 2 kilograms. I'm like, that's still massive. That's
some would say that's unhealthy, but that's amazing.
You said the other day you walked past and noticed your collarbones for the first time.
Yeah.
Very exciting.
Yeah.
Surprised by the attention my recent weight loss had received, nothing could distract me from my next dreaded beauty treatment. My first ever Brazilian wax. And no, apparently you don't have to be in South America to experience the old hot wax treatment. Brazilian waxes are hot right now in the celebrity world. Apparently going soft skin down below is a bikini body essential, even between the cheeks. Kim Kardashian certainly didn't beat around the bush, keeping us informed that she's completely hairless and her nether regions are as bare as a bone. Well, here goes nothing, literally.
You've never shaved?
No.
I'm not going to lie to you.
It probably is going to hurt a little bit. You want to take everything off?
Yeah.
Let's go for it.
Oh! Ouch! Oh. That one's tough.
Brazilian wax is one of the most painful things I've ever done. Some of the positions she asked me to lay on my side and, you know, open up and legs wide, spread eagle and clinging onto a butt cheek, and she was all up in there and... Tip 101 after getting a Brazilian wax, put some frozen vegetables on your crotch. Following a speedy recovery, I jumped onto Instagram to find solutions to my hunger. I discovered skinny detox teas.
So this one's the nighttime laxative and this is the breakfast one.
Fad diets come and go, but the detox trend seems to be here to stay, particularly when summer is looming. These therapeutic detox tea products claim to help shed kilos fast and get that bikini body you've always dreamed of. What many don't know is that these teas will have a severe laxative effect, which is exactly how they can help to shed the kilos. But in the process, also causes the individual to lose a lot of fluid and vitamins.
This has got to last you for the day.
Yeah, it's meant to quench my hunger. It's interesting that people would do this and have these teas just to lose weight.
Last night, I had one of the teas and I think I actually did it wrong, like terribly wrong. This is about 3 o'clock in the morning. I had to just stay in the bathroom. My stomach was audibly growling because I could not stop pooing. It sounds terrible, but I literally thought I would shit the bed if I laid in bed. I don't know why anyone would put themselves through that.
Spending most of the week working the toilet, my first hardcore CrossFit class had my body moving in a way it had never moved before. The CrossFit craze came to fruition in 2013, bringing with it a community of muscly diehard fans. Even the wonderfully wacky and sprightly Cameron Diaz is a huge fan of the fitness trend. She's frequently cited dragging tractor tires around LA. Basically, CrossFit is a high-intensity program blending elements of weightlifting, gymnastics, old-school gym exercises, circuit training, and aerobic conditioning. This was going to be a real treat.
Every single person in this class just shout out Comandy. And I owned it because I didn't know what else to do.
Finding it a bit hard with this raw diet. I'm starting to crave food a lot and getting really hungry. I don't think my 1,000 calories is enough.
Even though I could meet my friend out at the raw food cafe, calorie counting was consuming my mind. I didn't dare go over the 1,000 calorie limit.
I think my biggest anxiety at the moment is definitely the weight loss. Because there's some areas, especially my bottom, my thighs, my stomach, that just don't seem to be losing weight. I don't want to do all these diets and go on this search for perfection and not have that perfect frame, and I'm just anxious that I'm not doing enough. I'm going to go have some more laxative tea. I'll be best friends with the toilet tonight.
But it's not bad. I'm actually really happy with this.
Regardless of how the watercress soup tasted, I was eager for it to bring the same weight loss results as the cabbage soup. My mentality regarding food was certainly starting to change. Coming up to the halfway point of my journey, I checked in with both Fiona and Nurse Haley for an update on my health and progress.
So, raw foods was, I was looking forward to it because it had more versatility, but it was actually tough. The whole week, I was actually really disheartened because I only lost like 0.5 of a kilogram.
Okay, so at the moment it's about 105 and 68, which is still acceptable. I would say heading towards being that little bit low where you might feel a bit lightheaded.
I mean, you're now starting the fifth week. You're in full-on starvation mode.
At the moment, that blood sugar's good, so that's holding fine. I'd be concerned if it was, like, sitting below, say, 3.5.
So your body's going to be hanging on to as much fat as it can, and it will be using your own tissue, and that's essentially your muscle tissue with a bit of fat, to power your usual body functions.
Oh, okay.
92, exactly. So you've actually lost 10.1 kilos.
But what everyone else out there who isn't in the know assumes is that if you reduce the kilojoules by this amount, then it will have a steady rate of weight loss. But that's simply not the case. Our bodies aren't designed to do that. So what's next?
Watercress soup.
Oh, well, watch my eyes roll again. So the watercress soup diet is really just another reimagining of the cabbage soup. But you'll still be eating through your own muscle stores.
Next couple of weeks, my weight loss will plateau a bit.
It will still stall, yep, absolutely. Yeah.
You might find that you plateau.
Plateaus can last for 6 to 8 weeks. It's really an effect of extreme calorie deficiency.
So your BMI today is 30.4. So last time you were 33.7.
I'm so annoyed that I'm still in the obese category, especially because, like,
I don't know. How your clothes fit in. Yeah, feeling better. Yeah,
feeling better with weight. I really pushed myself, but yeah, I'm still classified as obese. I guess it just makes you feel really shit, really bad about yourself. All I want to do is lose more, and I completely forget about
the month of torture that I went through. It's motivating, but at the same time, I think a little bit dangerous.
I think your fitness is improving and then you run up this. Oh, right. Okay.
I couldn't believe just how much detail went into perfection. Not only should you be in shape and your makeup on point, but everything down to a perfectly manicured hand mattered. After not losing any weight, eating only bowls of green slush, I was extremely frustrated, and a combat boxing class seemed like the perfect way to let off some steam. Forget Pilates. A growing number of celebrity models, actresses, and musicians are turning to boxing to work up a sweat. Absolute babe and supermodel Gigi Hadid completely adores her time in the ring. And if boxing is her secret, well then you can sign me up. According to experts, boxing is not only a phenomenal cardio workout to whittle your waist and sculpt your body, but even better, female stars say the sport helps them tap into their inner strength, boosting their confidence and determination.
Natasha, this is my fighter. She's the best fighter in the world.
Okay.
Natasha, can you look after my friends here, my good friends, just in the ring? Just, oh, no, no, can you stay in the ring, stay in the ring. And jump in the ring with her.
Okay.
Natasha. And she'll just run you through the basics, stop. You know, bring it from your chin.
Okay.
From your chin.
Oh, you could really tell that I was a first-time boxer. I was hitting myself at one point in the head with my own glove because they were hitting me so hard.
Sorry, I felt so bad hitting you.
And what's so depressing is that after such a big day, I have to wake up and do it all again tomorrow.
Oh. Desperate times called for desperate measures, so I booked in for a weird hypoxia treatment that is all the rage right now. Hypoxia is a non-invasive treatment targeted at fat and cellulite reduction. The process combines exercise with vacuum technology. But the best part is you can watch TV or catch up on gossip mags without even breaking a sweat. And apparently, you can lose 3 times more weight than a standard exercise program. But when I heard skinny fanatic Kate Moss got one installed in her London home to work on her invisible cellulite, well, I just knew I should give it a crack too.
Now, once you start pedaling and the vacuum is on, it may feel a little bit different.
Under this cover, I'm actually pedaling. And I'm like, it's a normal steady pedal. And then I've got this belt around my middle that like sucks me in and out while I'm pedaling. My legs are still sucking. I can't get.
It's all about being sucked out of you.
It feels weird.
Not convinced that the hypoxia did anything, weight loss and calorie counting plagued my mind.
My roommates had a beautiful dinner last night and they were all having fun. Afterwards they went and watched a movie, and usually I would love that, but I honestly just ate my watercress soup and then ran away as fast as I could. I didn't want to be in a room where they were enjoying themselves eating food. I'm starting to feel guilty about eating foods that are in the diet. Like, I haven't cheated, I'm not eating chocolates or lollies. You can't tell people, oh, I ate some watermelon, I felt really guilty and I wish I hadn't eaten that watermelon. You can't say that to people, but in your head that's all you're thinking. And then you eat the next bit of food, you eat the spinach leaves and you're like, is this enough? Is this a handful? Have I calorie counted that right? If I eat this handful now, will I not be able to eat spinach tonight? Maybe if I don't eat the handful, maybe I should, maybe I don't. Oh, it's just curating. I hope I've done enough this week. It's a constant worry.
I'm going to reduce my overall calorie count by half and only have 500 calories a day.
No. I would caution you strongly against doing it.
I just feel like a mad person.
It feels to me like you're feeling wronged.
For the next month, I'm going to really dedicate myself to a personal trainer.
I could definitely drink that 3 times a day.
I'm starving. Sweated out all the juice that I've had this week. It just all came out. I just feel exhausted. I guess you could definitely say that I've become obsessed with this.